Hello, my name is Yuri Shevchenko. I'm the creator of OpenLab, and I'm also a postdoc at the chair of experimental psychology and internet research in the University of Konstanz in Germany. In this video, I'm going to talk about tasks in OpenLab. I assume that you haven't used OpenLab before, but you have created your task in lab.js and now looking for a way to put it online. I'm going to show you two ways to upload a lab.js task to OpenLab. I will talk about the differences between a public and private task, and will tell you how you can explore tasks available in OpenLab. First, let's start with the uploading of a task from the lab.js builder. So I'm going to open the lab.js builder, and let's assume that you already have your task prepared and now you're looking for the way to upload it online. I will pick up the city size task from one of the examples here in the lab.js builder. To upload the task, I will go to the menu and click on Upload to OpenLab. I have to confirm and click Upload here. Now the task gets uploaded to OpenLab, and when it's done, I should see the success message and will be able to proceed to OpenLab by clicking Manage Study on OpenLab. Now I'm on the OpenLab's page. It's important that you don't leave at this moment, but finish the upload. First, you have the option to change the task name here. Let's call it a city size. Then you can choose a cover photo for your task, so the display of your task can be a bit nicer for participants. You can of course skip this step or just click I'm feeling lucky to choose a random picture, then you will get a random picture. I'm going to use this option. Next, you can choose between making your task private or public. If you make your task public, other researchers can have access to it and see your code. If you are fine with that, please go ahead and choose it public. Otherwise, if it's a work in progress or you don't want to share the task with other researchers, keep it private. Sure, you still can use it in your own studies. If it's your first time in OpenLab, you have to create an account. If you already have one, just enter your email and password here, and please read the terms of service and privacy policy of OpenLab. By creating an account on OpenLab, we assume that you agree with them. So I'm going to create a new researcher account. Click Save when you're ready, and you will see the message, actually two messages. One message is that you're registered as a new user, and the message is that your task is uploaded. You can try your task to make sure that it works. Yes, it works. However, please don't stop here and start to share this link with your participants. This link is not for your participants. OpenLab has a more secure way and interface to run the study for participants. We are going to look at it a little bit later. For now, let's get accustomed to the interface of OpenLab. So this interface that you can see, this is for researchers like you. Remember that OpenLab will look differently for participants who will join your study. On the top navigation bar, you see the links. The first link is the link to the documentation. Please take your time if you want to get familiar with it. Next, you see the link to tasks. We have just uploaded one task, so if I go to the tasks, I should see that I have my task right here. I'm going to talk more about the tasks later after I introduce you all functionalities in the top navigation bar. Next to the tasks, you see the link to the studies. This will be the place to set up your own study. The idea of OpenLab is that your studies can combine several tasks. That is why we separate tasks and studies. A study can contain one task if you wish. It's important that you create a study since the data of the participants are linked to the study. In this way, you can reuse your tasks in many studies. There will be a separate video where I will talk about managing a study, so please check it after this one. The third link shows me the collected data in the study. Since I haven't created a study yet, it's empty here. In the separate video, I will talk about working with the data. Next, I have a text input field to search for the tasks. This search is done on all public tasks. On the right side, there is a drop-down menu to choose the study with which you want to work. Here, you can switch between different studies if you have more than one. Then there is a link to your profile information. Here I can edit the information about my account, such as, for example, change the language of the interface. English, German, and Russian are supported at the moment. If one of those languages is the default language of your browser, the interface will be already presented to you in your language. I'm using English version here, so if you have a different language version, you might consider switching to English to see exactly the same interface with me. I would also recommend to add your full name and your research institute right here. Especially if you make your tasks public, this information will be present with the task, so other researchers will know who is the author of the study. So let's come back to the task, but first I have to update my account and go back to the tasks. Now I'm looking at my own tasks. Each task is presented with a card. The buttons on the cards means the following, from the left to right. The first one means that you can run the task to test whether it works. The second button, that will allow you to edit the task. When I click on this button, I open the edit screen. Here, you can change the name and the description of the task. For your convenience, if you have several versions of the same task, you can write them right here. Then, if you upload the new lab.js JSON file, you don't need to go to the lab.js builder and do the same upload that we did before. You can just keep the JSON files in your local folder and make an update here when you're ready. You just need to upload the JSON file here. There is also option to change the cover photo and also add tags to your task, which might be helpful for other researchers to find your task if you make it public. So let's say I made some changes and I save it now. And let's just make a change with this city size task and save it. So I should see that my changes were applied. Now if I go back to my tasks and look at other buttons on the task card, the third button from the left is the button to download the JSON file of your task. You probably already have the JSON file of your task, but that function can come in handy later if you have many tasks or you accidentally have deleted the file from your computer. The fourth option is quite interesting one. It connects OpenLab with the lab.js builder. Clicking on it will open this task in the lab.js builder. I have to confirm that I want to load the study, and I have my study now opened in the lab.js builder. Let's come back to the OpenLab. So, and the last option is to delete the task. For safety reason, if you want to delete the task, you have to confirm deletion by typing the name of the task in the text field and then clicking on delete. One more indicator available on the task card is in the left lower corner that shows that this task is private, which means it's not available for other researchers. The last thing we will talk about in this video is the library of public tasks. To get there, click on the sub-navigation bar All Tasks. And here you will see the tasks that other researchers created and uploaded to OpenLab. You can open the separate page by clicking on the name of the task. You can also open the public task in the lab.js builder or download the JSON file. For security reason, OpenLab doesn't allow you to run other tasks from your research account, but you can always open the task in the builder and inspect the code. So let's say I open this visual search task, and now I can go inside and check the code. To summarize, in this first video, we got to know about how to upload your task in lab.js to OpenLab. However, we need one more step before we start inviting participants to our study, which is to create a new study. In the next second video, I'm going to show you how studies work in OpenLab. See you in the next one.